The HTC One M9 is the follow-on to the One M8, which was my favorite Android phone of 2014. The good news is, it's still good. The bad news is, it's barely any better than the One M8. Outside, it looks almost exactly the same. There's ridges around the edges that make it a little easier to grip. There's a new silver and gold two-tone color, and they took the power button and moved it from the awkward position on the top around to the side, which is still a little bit awkward, but it's better. The 1080p LCD, it's not bad, but it's not the best display I've seen. There's a lot of phones out there now with 2K displays, which is a lot more pixels, but you really don't need it on a 5-inch phone, so there's nothing wrong with this display. It's just not as good as it could be. The speakers, on the other hand, are as good as they can be. HTC still has the best speakers of any smartphone out there. You really cannot get a phone that sounds better than this one. Inside, the processor got an upgrade from the Snapdragon 801 to the Snapdragon 810, and from 2 GB of RAM to 3 GB of RAM, which on paper sounds like a big upgrade, but it's really not all that much faster. And unfortunately, battery life is worse. The M9 will take you all day without needing a recharge if you don't use your phone too much, but if you're the kind of person who plays games on the bus and is constantly checking your social media feed, you're gonna need to juice up near the end of the day. Probably the biggest change HTC made is in the camera. It really wasn't very reliable, and even when it took good pictures, they weren't very high resolution. In the One M9, HTC way overcompensated for that fault by putting in a big whopping 20 megapixel rear camera, and unfortunately, it's just not reliable. HTC really needed to get the camera right this time, and they just didn't. The One M9 comes with a new set of software called Sense 7, and it kind of looks exactly like Sense 6. There's a new widget on the home screen that changes the apps it displays depending on whether you're at home, at work, or out, but I really didn't find it very useful because I know where I put my app icons and I don't really need help finding them. There's a new theming app that I just love. You can change the background, the icons, the sounds, the fonts. I spent at least 2 hours making custom themes. They did a great job of balancing power with accessibility, and I think you're really gonna love it. Unfortunately, that's really all there is to the One M9. Where are the new technologies? Where's the fingerprint scanner, the wireless charging, anything? You wouldn't be bad off buying the One M9, but you're not really any better off than you were buying last year's model. The One M9 is just a tiny step forward, where HTC's competitors are making big strides. It's still a good phone, it's just nothing more than that.